Hello. Trails. There we go. Trails.
Trails in the sky.
All right. Thank you so much to Cephalon for the follow. Good to see when a parent supports their child. Okay. All right. So we last saved at the Caldea Tunnel just after passing Airleton, the checkmark, and we're heading to Zeiss. Through said Caldea Tunnel. Got a couple hours, a little under 3 hours to stream today. I've got some D&D to play, last run, at, 8 o'clock. So, oh, like a thieving heart. Well, we've seen that one already, unfortunately. Curia Bomb. Because you removed the contents, you looter. Oop, give me 1 second here. Hello, Squirrel Boy, how's it going? Hello, Fubar, how's it going? Here a bomb. Nope, still empty. Yeah, sorry, it was only late. I was gonna stream a bit earlier, actually, but I got caught up watching Lunchables stream some plus. And, yeah, it was just fun. So, I'm late. But, I don't know. Sometimes I've been late anyway, so, like, I figured it wouldn't be the end of the world. And it's still quite a few good long hours. There's a thing here. I don't want it to move. Ah! Okay. We're just gonna save real quick. Ah! Okay. I hope that's its back, but that is in fact its back. Cool. So we are back down to just Estelle and Joshua, which is a little bit unfortunate because having a third person is really nice a lot of the time, but whatever. He's also weak to water, right? Not water and wind. You're fire and wind. Oh, Jesus, right. How you doing, guys? How's the game today? Holy moly, okay. Man, Joshua packs a punch with that.
Good to go!
Holy shit, Joshua is also very much, like, underleveled. Deathblow 2. Okay, I thought that there was a, yeah, there is a secondary kind of like half. I thought there was maybe even a third section to this place as well. I'm not sure. There's an urban charging station. Surely nothing bad will happen to us when we move forward along this tunnel. Joke's on you, actually nothing bad happens. Caldea Limestone Cave is up ahead, and then the Zeiss region is over to the right, which cuts off on the map, that's fine. I'm kind of doing my thing where I just don't really want to fight random encounters right now. I'll grind it out later when I actually need to. Warning! Beware of monsters! Okay. And we're gonna go here. So just what we need. Boink, like this one? Celestial Ball, nice. Aha! You again! Not sure what you mean. This is the first time I'm seeing you, sir. Bomb. You may now fill it with your tears. Those random encounters still got you down? Yeah. I feel like there's a way to circumvent them. I know with a chocobo you don't get any, but you might not be at that point yet. We've got to hurry. Huh? Someone's coming this way. Girl, good afternoon. Where's the fire? Good afternoon. Are you taking this road too? Well, yeah. Have you seen any lights that weren't working? The lights all along the tunnel wall, I mean. Sorry, if there are, I haven't noticed any. But then, yeah, levels. Yeah, that's the RPG problem, unfortunately. All of the lights we passed were still on, but we did pass one that was flickering. There's two rivers between it and here. I don't remember this at all. That's it. It's just like I thought. Sorry, I have to hurry. Goodbye. I wonder if she's from Zeiss. Strange little kid. He seemed awfully flustered. Now I'm kind of worried. You want to try following her? He read my mind. I don't like the idea of a little girl wandering around here by herself. You should catch up to her and stick close. Alright, let's go catch this small child. I can't stop. It's so catchy. It's called Prowling in the Dark, I believe. If you want to look up the song title. Say again. Sigh. Can't believe there are so many of them. It's going to break at this rate. Maybe this. That was the in-game music. Bearing set, angle of elevation 20 degrees, orbital compression at 30%. Go! If you come any closer, then I won't miss next time. I mean it. Oh no. I've read enough. Never mind. Oops, I think that might have made them angrier. Ah! Yeah! What? Hey, I remember you. We can talk later. Get back. Gotta get rid of these things first. Okay. I have no idea what these things are. Damp crawlers. Clever monster living in the darkness. Use sticky fluid to weaken its prey. I hit two. Not hit two. Probably all gonna move up a bit. Majora's Mask soundtrack is fucking awesome, yeah. Ow! Yeah, let's throw up an earthball. That'll be pretty good. Tita. Her name is Tita. I don't know. Smoke cannon. Yeah! Missed. Well, she missed the one in the back, I think? Or the one in the front? I actually don't know. It's the one in the front. For sure. Okay. Okay. Gummy juice! Ow. Ooh, speed down. Ow. Alright, now I can hit a couple of them. Nice. Killed one. Oh yeah, I didn't see that Estelle had taken damage too, actually. How's the audio balance? Everything sounding okay? Smoke cannon! Look at this, look at this. It's a craft with a size like that, and you can set it freely. It's really good.
Prepare to meet your doom!
Prepare to meet your doom! She's so cute, I love her. Game's a bit loud? Okay, yeah, that's what I was thinking. I'll turn it down. Just a little bit. That should be better. Okay. Boop, boop. There we go. How's that? Tita doesn't get hit. Tita. I'm gonna call her Tita. That's better? Awesome. Gummy juice! Ow! God, she can hurt. I was really worried about that. We're gonna make sure that he doesn't get a turn.
Did it.
Damn, that's a lot. That was scary. Thank you very much. I thought I was a goner for sure. Well, the important thing is that you're safe, but you really should be more careful. Stirring up monsters is a surefire way to get yourself eaten. I skipped that one. If I'd left them alone, they probably would have broken that light. Speaking of which, why would those things go after the lights anyway? Don't they do the same thing when the highway lights are switched out? Deceptium in those circuits is the monster's favorite food. When they stop working, they have the exact opposite effect. Still, you shouldn't mess with something like that. Deceptium might be their favorite food, but little girls probably rank a close second. Giving her nightmares and saying, don't do that, isn't exactly going to score you any points. Oh, don't be such a wet blanket. Anyway, my name's Estelle. I'm Joshua. We're bracers, affiliated with the guild. Oh, so that's why you're so tough. I'm Tita. I work as an apprentice at the Central Factory. That's pretty impressive. Well then, Tita, we're heading to Zeiss, so do you want to join us the rest of the way? You don't want to be around here if the monsters show up again. Do you mind waiting for a little bit? I've got to get that light fixed. How in the world did you know it had burned out, though? Well, I was lucky enough to notice the problem when I was looking in the computer database. Seems like a defective unit was installed here by mistake. Computer? Database?
Metal Gear?
Okay, that should do it. Sorry it took so long. Tell her me impressed. Well, she's an apprentice at the Central Factory. She has to be good. I just fixed the quartz connection and adjusted the orbital pressure. Well, it sure sounds special. It's not that big a deal. Okay, how do I explain this? Each orbit has a quartz circuit inside, and if that isn't properly connected, the orbital energy inside the unit will have nowhere to go. As a result, the orbit won't be able to function properly. This happens sometimes with the highway lights, which means their ability to give out light and ward off monsters is compromised, so stop! Maybe you should save the explanation for after we get on the road. This game is set during a period known as the Cold War. I'm just kidding. I mean, if we stand around too long, the monsters, you know. Yes, sir. So this is actually why that Orban charging station is here. I forget what the exact intro, like, dialogue, monologue, whatever is. I know it's this period, this marked the beginning of a period known as the Cold War, is the end of it. I don't really know why, like, ran into this pair of monsters. But, I don't know, Ariel, I guess. And Ariel, I guess. Oh, she ran right up there, eh? Okay. Alright. Cool strike on the tortoise, which will maybe not take a lot of damage. Nope, never mind. Oh, she can't hit it. Oh, that's one of those things. Hey, how about that? Cool. Long ago in a distant land, I, Aku, a shape-shifting master of darkness, unleashed an unspeakable evil upon this land. But a foolish samurai warrior, wielding a magic sword, stepped forth to oppose me. Before the final blow was struck, I tore open a portal in time and flung him into the future where my evil is law. This marked the beginning of a period known as the Cold War. What do I want to give her? I definitely want to give her the long barrel, actually. As well as the... I don't know. Really, Lily Nicholas is fine. Her ornament is weird. Yeah, not great. She's got an EP cut, which is pretty good. And a movement, too. Okay, she has a couple of space quartz only slots. I think it's this one and this one here. Oh geez. Range 1, that's arts only, right? Yeah. Put that move one right there. Put hit three there. Put defense three, and then... Holy gosh, he has no hit points. Shield three, I guess. For now, we'll unlock these slots. Actually, Clank is actually, like... They're not someone I would be really opposed to in Smash. I think they're interesting characters. And I think, yeah. They could work a lot like Banjo. Kazooie. Banjo and Kazooie. Does that mean this is the entrance to Zeist? That's right. It leads right into the basement of the Central Factory. I'm excited to see it. The Central Factory is the pride and joy of Zeist, since it's an industrial city. I heard it was big, but that's about all I really know. Well, yeah, it's really huge. Anyone who's not used to the layout could get lost in a hurry. That's a creepy thought. I'm beginning to worry whether or not we'll really be able to make it to the guild. The way out to the city is up on the first floor. I'll show you how to get there. Let's see. Holy God. Okay, quartz list, armor list, only include new work jumpsuit, metal jacket. Just double checking the walkthrough thing. I need to Sanctine Gate? What? Ow. The broken. Oh, yeah, okay. I was thinking of Garoon Gate, but kind of the same thing. Katamari Prince, yeah, I think you've mentioned that before. Seven chests in Chaldea Tunnel? I'm not sure if I actually got all seven. I might have. There are a lot of side quests. I don't know why. I am yawning so much. Okay. Left elevator, right apartment, basement. Oh, what's this place? Looks like almost the entire factory is completely automated. Below the city, there are lots of Orbin factories. They make everything from lights to airship parts. Okay, what's this room? This is the elevator. It can take us from the basement to the roof. Can't say I've ever seen one of these outside of the mines, and this one seems super high-tech. Elevators! Holy moly! Reception desk and consumer maintenance windows are... Oh, Tito. Miss Hazel, here you are. Supervisor Travis has been looking for you. He'd like for you to go straight to the operations room. Oh, okay, I will. I always wanted a sweet, lovable little sister like her. Instead of, might I add, an obnoxious little brother. You keep saying things like that, but you're the one who's always following me around. You want to be more like a real older sister, you need to get your head out of the clouds every now and then. Look who's talking. Anyway, all sibling rivalries aside, want to head into the city? Tragically, we can't open her slots until she rejoins. We have a bit of more stuff we can make. Like some cast twos, actually. That's pretty good. I'd love a cold one. Oh, goddamn it. Recipes. Briam's Drinkstead. Oh, it's all just stuff if you miss it earlier, which I have not. I know all the recipes for it. Irene's Flower Stand. He sells bear claws for 10 bucks. That's super good. Wait, did I actually buy that? No, I did not. What the heck? There we go. That's the landing port, which we did not really... Oh, yeah. Ugh. What's this? Some kind of moving staircase. It is a really long climb, so I guess it would be tough without it. Yeah, but to have the whole thing moving underneath you? This place has been full of surprises ever since we got here. Alright, so we have a tough decision ahead of us. I believe that if you don't already have it like I do, you get an achievement for running down the wrong one. Staircase that moves. Incredible. Stay in Arms and Guards has the means to fill your needs. My shop is just across the street from the Racer Guild, so drop by anytime. Literally gonna go there right now. To the site of fell accoutrement, make your palms sweaty. Well, shop here. We cater to the violently inclined. It's the best tagline for a weapons shop ever. Spike rod, I already have one. Basilards, Gherkin knives, PO3, craft cannon. I don't have a craft cannon. I'm gonna buy a craft cannon. Metal jackets. What are we currently wearing when the ADF is so much? Oh, like nothing. Craft shoes? Nice. Alright, we can put on some new stuff. We gotta buy that. Hey, there we go. I just got the achievement for Armor Connoisseur. Actually, come to think of it, because I'm literally doing an achievement slash whatever playthrough, let me just adjust my stream settings really quick here and capture those. Why does that break it? There we go. Cool. Alrighty. So, I'm on Spike Rod. Battle suit. Metal jacket. Craft shoes. Gherkin knives. Metal jacket. Craft shoes? Craft shoes. Alright. That's good. Solid bunch of upgrades there. Bell Station General Goods. Woolly knit hat. I believe I need that for a quest. So since even though I didn't have one, I needed to buy a second one. Because I need to do that quest again, and when you do the quest, it gives it away, so that's why I didn't have one. Pirates or ninjas? Pardon the sniffles, as always. Where else? Oh, there's a pub? Orgle Bar? Orgle Bar. Orgle? Can't talk to you? Can we talk to you? Water, bouillon, vegetables, and pepper. Let's see. Boop. Rotini pasta. Need that. Black pepper soup, we need that. Seasonal tart, we need that. Okay, we should be good to stop in at the Bracer Guild. Hi there. Pardon us. Eastern woman. See, we're finally here, I see. Estelle, Joshua, welcome to Zeiss. Huh? You know us? I've already been briefed of your arrival from one John at the Ruin Branch. A girl with chestnut hair, tied in twin ponytails, and a boy with black hair and amber eyes. That is you, is it not? Okay. My name is Kilika. Zeiss welcomes your service. It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Same here. Pleasure is ours. I know you've only just arrived, but I'd like to proceed with the formalities of changing your affiliation. You'll just sign these documents. Okay. That should do it. You're both now affiliates of the Zeiss Regional Guild. There are no urgent matters that must be seen to you currently. You're free to check the bulletin board and work at your own pace. It's kind of disappointing, but hey, a little peace and quiet can be a good thing. Oh, right. I had a question to ask. About Cassius, correct? She can read minds! Did John tell you about him, too? The whole sordid matter. I'm sorry to have to say that Cassius is not currently in the Zeiss region. He only stops in every few months or so. That just leaves Grand Cell. Or maybe. I believe I might be able to provide you with a lead in another matter. Please, take this. Received attention, Factory Chief. What's this? It is a letter of introduction to the head of the central factory, one Mr. Murdoch. He's basically like the mayor of the Zeiss region. This in regards to the matter of the Black Organ. Stories of the mayor's residence painted as a very mysterious item. I'd suggest that you consult with the factory chief and see what he has to say. You've really got this all planned out. Do you have some kind of superpower, Kilika? My business is to provide support for bracers, such as yourselves. I simply decipher the intelligence that's provided and pass it on as the mandates of my job require. Wow. We really appreciate your assistance. Think nothing of it. I trust that you will return to assist us should a major incident occur. He's pretty straightforward. Chronocider. There's not much up here. Okay. Trap Plains Road, right? That's where that one was. Yep. Well, I'm not going to do that unless I have to, so let's double check the quests. Also, just double checking the Shining Palms locations. Oops. Storm entering Maple Leaf Inn. There's a bunch of quests where I need to do that. Oh. We are from the Bracer Guild. We'd like to meet with the factory head if we may. Estelle reached into her pouch, paused for dramatic effect, and then flourished the introduction note to meet the factory chief. Joshua looked stoic and tried not to roll his eyes.
I see.
Keeping one wary eye on Estelle all the while.
Yes, sir, right away. Thank you for waiting. Factory Chief Murdoch will see you again. His office is upstairs on the second floor.
Nice, I didn't think he'd see us so quickly.
Not keep him waiting.
Jokes on them, I'm gonna keep them waiting.
So, second floor, I believe his office is marked.
Archives.
Excuse me, we saw your request from the bulletin board.
The archives loaned out some books to various central factory departments. Sometimes they keep them past the due date and don't pay the fees. First, I'd like you to get our books back. Second, I'd like you to break their kneecaps. Let's see, they should be in the third floor design room and the fourth floor lab and clinic.
Third floor?
Design room?
Found septium optic analyst?
It's not in the workshop. However, haven't we...
What? Now that you mention it,
we did meet previously when we were in ruin.
I thought so. You two were a real help that time. I appreciate you finding the orbital gun prototype for me.
Oh yeah, you're that science guy.
What'd all your research and stuff end up doing anyway?
Interesting how totally blasé they are about, you know, weaponry being on the shelves, but especially with how, like, troubled by war this whole region was, like, you'd think that there would be more people who are like, hey, let's not have guns kicking around or anything.
You, give me a book. There it is.
Kitty Talk for Dummies.
The Zeiss music is really, really nice. I like it a lot.
Tomorrow's cooking.
Anti-nap food product sample.
That's like calling mouse straps on your earlobes anti-sleep aids.
Who would like to sample my tomato?
Received acerbic tomato.
Yeah.
Well, that's the bitter tomato he was talking about, actually, and we need that for stuff. I forget what stuff though. But it's pretty relevant, pretty quick.
Yeah.
Oh shit, I meant to read them. Or at least attempt to.
Perhaps I should go ahead and ask you for help with my favorite type of work.
Oh, that's right. You mentioned having some significant problems somewhere along the line.
Just like before, we need some overdue materials returned. The book in question is called The Herb Woodpecker.
Approach the man of stone, standing in silence within the mountain village pond, and ye shall receive.
Okay, I wrote that down, but what the heck is it?
It was written on a card that was taken from the book. I imagine that it's some kind of hint as to its whereabouts.
Hint of bad poetry, maybe. So it was only borrowed because someone with way too much time on their hands wanted to hide it somewhere?
Evidently so. It's the sort of trick that researchers used to play on each other long ago. I have no idea what would possess someone to hide a book of all things, but we certainly have our fair share of unusual characters. It's not surprising that any of them might follow such a bizarre custom. Anyway, I leave this matter in your capable hands. Please, bring the book back.
I definitely did not do this quest to the fullest in my first playthrough, so I'm looking forward to following it to its end. On that note, I'm going to actually attempt to do that exactly now. That said, it does require me to go to somewhere I'm not supposed to go yet. I need to go south. Trapped Plains Road. I just ran down the down escalator. God, what am I going to do with myself? Playthrough's canceled. Everybody go home. Just, I fucked up. Everything's over. All over. Yeah. Ha ha! Got the drop on him. Oh, it's just one thing. Armored Rabbit. Attacks with a deadly strike. Doesn't take no damage or anything, so that's good. So, Trap Plains Road is enormous. Full of sheep and snakes. I need a bunch of chests in it. There's like 9. 4 of them have monsters in them. Look at this shit. Look at how big this shit is. But Elmo Village is where we're headed. You're a bomb. Wouldn't be empty if you hadn't already looted it, now would it? Oh, we can actually make it to Elmo. Autumn Souvenirs has some stuff we need, I think. Fluffy Spring Egg. That's what we need. Hey, it's new people. Nice. A little date vacation to the hot springs. That boy over there is one major hottie. Maple Leaf Inn. Here we go. There's more stuff I need here, too, I think. Yep. Wild Veggie Pot, Fruity Milk, Specialty Eggnog, and Monster Seed. Okay, I've already had that. Makes sense. Fruity Milk? Speed plus 30%? You shitting me? Pick a couple of those. Ooh. Pick a couple of those. That's only okay. Pretty good, but only okay. Because there's nothing like a hot bath after fishing. Cleaning in progress. Shit. Can we get this? Oh. Oh, you can actually go down here? I literally never knew that. This angle. Holy moly. At the stone. What? What is this? Approach the man of stone, standing in silence within the mountain village pond, and ye shall receive. Where's the stone lamp? There's supposed to be a stone lamp. Because, like, that thing. Hello? Aha! Wow, this is tricky to get to. Found a package wrapped in oiled paper. Inside was the herb woodpecker. That is out of the way. Wow. Can I read it? I can read it. Oh no, I might need to reload and read those. Actually. Do I need to read those? Let me double check the achievements. Spoiler warning! Let me double check the achievements. Ha 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 ha. Okay, I don't know. FC books. Is there a, let's see. Wait, whoa, what? Holy moly. Huh, okay. Okay, so there isn't an achievement necessarily for getting all of the books and or reading all the books. I need to read all the chapters of Carnelia, which is fine. And I need to read all the chapters or all the issues of the Liberal News. Is also fun, so I don't need to restart. However, I'm going to make a save point right here, just in case, as well as right there, which I believe was before this, or before I turned in those three from the factory. I will also be right back in just a second, because I just need to grab a glass of water. One moment. Let's see. There are a lot of side quests. An awful lot of side quests. I don't want to fight a bunch of enemies just yet. I'm not done. Except, we do need to fight Shining Palms, and they spawn right up around here, apparently. But you don't have to do that just yet. There is also supposed to be a large monster kicking around here somewhere. I'd like to find it so I know where to go. Ah, there it is. Okay, it's literally just on the path, so that's fine. We need to go to the Wolf Fork.
More like Wolf Fart.
I'm glad I have viewers that enjoy my highbrow, sophisticated humor.
Chickens!
Alright. NPC Private Bram.
up.
Back in Squat's pub, I'm Rufus. I'm afraid both of the proprietors stepped out. Oh. Anything here? Vegetable sandwich. Tanya, it's... we're starting to pick up and hear a few more of the, what? Starting to hear a few more of the more, like, unique tracks. Which is really good. That's Private Bram. Supposed to have a quest for me. Oh, the wolf fort. That's Calvert. I did not know that before. Okay, so we can't get through here or start this quest, unfortunately. I know, right? 99. It's okay. The requirement for affiliate is only 50, and I hit that kind of ages ago, obviously, so... not in a rush. I'm just gonna keep doing what I'm doing, and, you know, if I build it, they'll come, hopefully, sort of thing. I'm getting a lot of traction on my, YouTube Smash videos, like my Smash videos on YouTube. Lots of views and, quite a few comments. Complimenting my Roy and stuff. Well, that's been nice. Make the bed! You shut up a second. I'm looking for a book. Oh, sack, what? I'd trade her for Professor Russell's granddaughter Tita in a second. Look at all that. Character backstory plot lore that we just got there. Where are we going? Second floor archives, I believe. Found it! You betcha. Brought you your book. Like there was ever any doubt. For the rest of the work. Here's more. The next book's hint has no words. What in the fuck? I'm trying really hard not to just stare right at the walkthrough and figure this out on my own and like, what the fuck? You've gotta be kidding. No comments or anything. The name of the book in question is Hurt's Adventure 2. What does that look like in our book? This time the hint is a diagram. Okay, where is it? Exactly where I thought it would be, actually. I didn't remember the place, like, visually exactly, but I had a general idea of where it might be. There's a specific part out on the Trap Plains Road that I almost went to already, but decided I would come back to you later. It's along the way to the wolf fort. Look at all these monsters. Look at all these sheep. Sleepy sheep. It is dead ahead. Meow. Observe. One. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4 pillars. Hurt's Adventure 2. Yeah, I'm really happy about people seeing my Smash gameplay and stuff. I mean, obviously I'm also posting it in, like, the regional Smash Discords I'm in and stuff, so it's Probably just a couple of them, but I'm aware broadcasting is enabled. Steam, go away. Oh, okay. It went away. Cool. Meow. I already ate all of my fruit snacks. My god. Oh, did you find the book by any chance? Indeed we have. Last one is entitled 31 Cypress Trees. And here's its card. It's got more of that unusual writing on it. Oh, what the fuck? Ah, you 31 cypress trees nestled atop this grassy hill. Afflictions of the far off lands draw nigh unto me like wine barrels, tumbling lightly down a soft incline as I drift into reverie, enveloped within the resonance of the tolling bell. What in the fuck? I'm literally looking at the walkthrough and the guide thing. I know where it is. I'm trying to figure out how you figure it out. A-N-G-M-U-I-R-E-B? Enquired? That can't be right. There's a 3FL in brackets. Oh, I forgot the H. A-N-G-H-N. It makes no sense already. U. Do we count the I as a capital letter or what? Reb? B-E-R-I-U. Run Hugna? This doesn't make any sense. What the fuck? Maybe it'll make sense when we get there. Weeza going this way. What the hell? That's literally one of the giant watery monsters, or whatever. I'm mostly sad about not having gained a follower on stream in a little while, because... Well, no, I guess I've gotten one or two, but... Which Norse mythological figure was that? Dude, your guess is as good as mine. What do you think? We're looking for a book. So we've got, like, A... I'm looking at the capital letters A N G H and you barrel I R E B. Okay, so hang on. A N G. Let me type this into Twitch chat. And you I R E B. Those are all the capital letters in this thing. What is it even? What? How the hell do you figure this out? Do we need that FL maybe? What issue is that, aside from literally all of it? This isn't like a fucking cipher or anything, is it? I want to Google this. I want to figure out how you figure this out. I'm just going to Google this. Nestle the top this. Oh wait, no. Let's just do the temp librarian plus 3. This doesn't say anything. Description. Okay. Oh, okay. Well, okay. I'm looking too hard into it. It's literally just 3FL barrel. Third floor barrel, and that is indeed where we're going. There are only two places in this region that have third floors. One is right here. Not right here. Run is, you know, where I'm going, Sanctum Gate. And the other is in the central factory, which the book is not there, so. Gundolf? It's Gandalf, but with a shotgun. Hell yeah. Damn that Wong. Poor Wong. What did he ever do to you? Anyway. Remember that kid who was looking for the quartz fragment in Roland, don't you?
Oh, yeah!
Interesting. Third floor. Look, it's a barrel. Package was found, wrapped in oil paper. Inside was 31 cypress trees. I don't know how they got them all in there, but... Huh? What's wrong? There's a card stuck in the book, and something's written on it. You have done well. Though I know you not, I salute you for coming so far. Allow me to introduce myself. I am a quartz researcher, and the criminal who hid the three books. I have used the riddles as a way to find someone intelligent to whom I can entrust my work. And you lived up to my hopes and expectations remarkably. Consider the enclosed quartz your reward. Take care when examining it. Thank you for all your time. I truly hope that my quartz will prove useful to you. Yes, if you have found this package by sheer chance, how embarrassing, and lucky you, please return it to the second floor archives of the Central Factory. Oh right, Impede 3. Nice. I actually don't know if I know that there was an Impede 3 in the game. I sure as shit didn't. 50% success, that's super good. The Burl's Finest. Royal Avenue. Oh, right. This way is towards Grand Cell. I forget about Grand Cell existing a lot of the time, which is kind of awkward and silly considering it's where, like, a very large and important chunk of the game takes place, being that it's the last chapter's area. I mean, spoiler alert, but pattern is pretty obvious, so... Else worth talking to in here? This food is surprisingly good at the inn my daughter runs. I do hope Private Jules can make it, you giggle. Pot of meat? We already have that, but just be sure. Already have the rotini pasta and already have the vegetables. Somebody pointed out that that riddle might have made more sense in the original language. Which is, I think, a fair assessment, but, you know. EP Charge EX. You came back! I knew you would. Hold that Army Road. Oh yeah, that leads to Laceton Fortress, which we don't need to go to yet. We need to go bring this book back. Perchance have you? Yep, we have the last book. Is the thief question mark? Temp Librarian plus 2, Temp Librarian plus 3. That's a whole shitload of VP that I missed the first time through. Makes sense. Alright, I think it's safe to say we can meet the chief now. We're gonna save just in case. Hey, I've been waiting for you two. Estelle and Joshua, right? Yes, it's nice to meet you, sir. Sorry to bother you at work like this. No, don't worry yourselves about that. The Bracer Guild, and Cassius in particular, have done a great deal for me in the past. It would be rude of me not to welcome his children. You know, Dad? I guess you might say that. He was my benefactor. No exaggeration to say that the Central Factory produces the finest organs in the land. Naturally, the confrontations over our craft have never really stopped. Whenever we had a problem, we'd always contact the Roland branch and have him come over. That explains all the business trips, then. And now, my benefactor's kids come to visit me themselves. What can I do for you? I'm happy to help. Help there. Obviously made from modern materials, but the caliber isn't inscribed anywhere. You mean the numbers that are carved into the ordnance frame? Exactly. It's almost unheard of for an ordnance to be produced without them. That's not just in Liberal, either. Most other nations on the continent are the same way. It's been a tradition dating back to when the ordnance were first invented 50 years ago. Right, there are numbers, right there. Crazy. You mean to say that you've never noticed in all this time? Hush. But seriously, is it really that strange for one to have no caliber on it? It's pretty much a part of the production process, and that goes for any Orgel factory. As if this one were a prototype or something. If so, I'd imagine it wasn't made to entertain at birthday parties, if you take my meaning. The less with the sweet and awesome, more with the stabby hurdy. Got it. Can't find the maintenance cover. Now that I really look at it, it seems it has no seams to it at all. How the hell was this thing made? I don't see any way to check out the inside of it. There was a note that was included with the ornament. Please ask Professor R to do an analysis. You wouldn't have to know who this Professor R is, would you? But let me think. From the letter R and the people that Cassius knew, it must be Professor Russell. I thought so. You're Professor Russell. And wait a second, how do you know this guy? I don't, but I know of him. He's known as the person who brought orbital technology to Liberal in the first place. Ordnance were invented by Professor Epstein, who didn't kill himself, absolutely not, and Professor Russell was one of his disciples. 40 years ago, he brought the ordnance and his knowledge back, and that's why Liberal is a technologically advanced nation. You might say that he was the father of the Orbital Revolution. Actually, I've been looking for you. Sorry to bother, but can you come here? Oh, no, no. He actually has a private workshop in town. He has all the latest technology at his disposal, so I know he can figure out something about that thing. And who did you call? His granddaughter. She works here at the factory. I'm sure the child will be happy to show you the way. Hooray! The reveal that we spoiled! Hooray! Yay, now we've got her. Doors locked. It's all over now. Doors locked. Yeah. Oh. Look at all this nothing up here. Operations. Doors locked. Hi, fam. Can't use this yet? Lame. Fourth floor. On the fourth floor. I forget what's on the fourth floor. The clinic. how we sew the insole. But no, you're literally talking about the quest I want. Whoops, look at the time. I have to finish this tour. Sorry, Ray. I'll talk to you later on, okay? Design room. Okay. Looks like we can't quite advance until we go to the first floor slash keep the house. However, we can open all her organ slots. Openable. Openable. Perfect. Oh yeah, we can also equip her with some stuff. Like the metal jacket, I think? No. Did we just buy it? Yes, the metal jacket and craft sheet. Oh, and the P-Craft Cannon. Yep. Move to hit 3, fence 3, spaceports. Range 1, Eagle, I'll give her Eagle Eye and give Joshua something better. Like EP Cut 3, maybe. Oh, hell yeah. Clock up EX? Hell yeah. Oh, HP 3 does not get her very much. I could give her attack 3. Oh, yeah. I wanted to give her impede, honestly. 80%? What? What was I looking at? Why does she have an impede? Why does she do way better? What's going on? Am I crazy? Oh, I looked at 10, 20, 50. I'm dumb. I looked at sleep, I think. Yeah, we're definitely going to give it to her. Oh, she's quite a bit weaker, unfortunately, but... But what if? 159, 116. I really don't want to take off her hit 3 because that's like super, super strong for her. And taking off her defense would probably be just like bad. Although, what does it give her? 156, 136. That's 20 points. That's too much. Shields. 49 to 19, I assume. Yeah. I don't want to take off that or that. Impede 3 is good. I wonder how much I'd actually need it, though. Yeah, it's... I don't know. I can't give her an attack thing, so... Man. Her job is not quite so much to actually do the damage. I just want her to shoot things and pester them, basically. You're with the professor's granddaughter, aren't you? I never got all this very, very amusing side dialogue about Kilika being literally psychic. This is my house. Well, we have our third character. I don't remember how many more we get. What? Oh, there he is. Grr! Okay, maybe this way. Grr! Arrgh! like me playing with Lego. Got it! Who's the man? Oh, the man. Yes, I should start testing it at once. Whoa! What the hell? Grandpa kind of goes into a trance when he's working. He doesn't really notice what's going on around him. I think he just finished up the device he's been working on for the past few days. I'm so embarrassed. Sick balcony! Whee! Alright. This new invention will actually block a biosensor orbit's detection faculties. It emits a unique orbital force field that deflects the energy that a biosensor sends out when it scans. Hey, you with the black hair. Me? Who else? On the upstairs bookcase is a notebook titled Orbital Energy as Applied to Force Fields. Go get it. Go on, be quick about it. All right. Hey, young lady, you with the antenna hair. Antenna? Oh no, you didn't. Quit farting around and make some coffee. Why should I have to make you coffee? I take it black, by the way. I want it clear as mud. You're not hearing a word I say. Fine, whatever. Where is still Joshua?
Who?
Come to think of it, I do vaguely recall a couple of young folks. Murdoch sent along some fresh faces then, I presume? Grandpa? After many small but relatively harmless explosions and some singeing of the eyebrows, the day gave way to evening. The only thing you had me helping was making coffee. Girls can bang metal parts together too, old man. Want to give up this bracer nonsense and start up in the field of orbital engineering? Not some old fart with attention deficit issues. Ah, me IRL. Please, you're too kind. You had the really nice mustache, right? I don't know if I'd call it nice so much as suspicious looking. But if he's known Dad for that long, it looks like we'll be safe and trusting you know what with Professor Russell after all. What are you talking about? And what was it you wanted my help with? Yeah, the one metal part that she's talking about is her own skull, I'm sure. Also, hello. Push the blade's edge against the outer shell of the orbit. Wait, what are you doing? It's a special alloy steel cutter. Just as I thought. Here, take a look. Okay. Not even a scratch. The frame is made from some type of metal that I've never before encountered. Opening it up for a closer look is going to be quite the task, I think. That's just crazy. If we can't find some way to open it, we'll be right back to square one. Well, I can certainly spend some time on trying. But first, I think that maybe we should put it under a measurement scan. What, man? That huge piece of equipment you saw when we were working on the experiment. It can gauge orbital energy activity in real time. You're making my head to hurt with your techno babble. Just tell me what using that thing will accomplish. In English, nerd! We'll see what it do. You won't be able to draw any definitive conclusions just from measuring what kind of orbital activity is occurring, but it's a start. It should give us a major clue. Shouldn't we have lunch first? Sure. The day gave way into evening, and we're going to have lunch. Hell yeah. My house, my rules! Put the ornament on the stand. Like this? Yes, thank you. Now commencing orbital force measurement test on the Black Ornament. Black Ornament? So that's going to be the official name after all? But using it officially is so boring and simple. Why not something cool like Dark Thingy of Impending Doom? No, simple is best. Anything longer than Black Ornament would be just annoying to say. Fidget, fidget. Output set at 45. Put all measuring equipment on standby. Roger. Done. All measuring equipment is calibrated. Okay, from here on out is the real deal. Since no direct input or output was detected, all we can do is measure how the central crystal circuit responds. Now let's see just how much this contraption has really worked. You're sure in a good mood. And click! Me when I F-smash people. Neat. It's all glowing and stuff. I get it. It's putting a major strain on the crystal circuit. Dita, any readings? Yes, but they're kind of weird. The tachometer needle's shaking like crazy. Tachometer? Tachometer? And now it's spinning around the dial. What?
It's the main theme again, if you were listening, if you were wondering.
Well, a little bit. What's going on here? It's that same black light from before. What? Whoop! Plunk! Yo, what the fuck?
Who turned out the lights?
My glasses!
I can't see anything without my glasses.
It won't take much more of this. We have to shut it down. Don't you dare! Just a little longer and we'll have something. All the lights in town are going out.
Huh?
What? Ah, we have no choice then. Terminating the experiment. Oh, they're back on. It didn't record anything. I'm getting awful, awful PTSD from the second game. And the only thing that kept working was the scanner on which the black orbit sat, but even that, well, as for everything else, like the experiment's finished. How's it outside? Fine, all the lights are back like nothing happened. There's still a lot of people panicking, though. But just what the hell was all that? That was what I would dub the orbital shutdown phenomenon. The what down? The hoedown? You mean how everything inside all the orbits just stopped working at once? But the black orbit did this? Yes, I've no doubt. But I would never have dared to guess that its effect would be so extensive. Are you currently playing it right now? There's definitely more to this than I expected. Interesting. Most interesting indeed. Only you would think causing a blackout over an entire city is interesting. That's, like, objectively wrong. That's pretty fucking interesting. Ah, Murdoch, just the man I wanted to see. The feeling is not mutual. Every single time you invent something, it means trouble for me. Oh, you're at third now? Okay, no spoilers for third. I haven't played third. I've only played the first two. Kind of the whole point of this replay through. What the hell were you up to that would cause all of the power downtown to go out? How rude. It's not even my fault this time. See that there? That's the black ornament, and it caused this. Is that the... Okay, I get it. If that's the root of this, then it's genuine extenuating circumstances. But it still means that this was your fault! Ah, nuts, you got me. That's it? They're just okay again? Are they always like this? This is so embarrassing. You know, it's pretty surprising how little that they, like, bunk at the bracer guilds that seem to kind of come equipped with lodgings. Where the hell were these? What? Now that his equipment's gone all kerflooey. I've heard a couple things about it. And I'm sure I will, but yeah. I don't have a lot of details or anything. I know there's something about doors. Yeah, that's kind of what I'm expecting, just post-development, post-character, post-arc, I don't know, post-game character development stuff. Expose all the Black Orbment secrets. Black Orbment gate? Water gate? No. I don't know. The Panama Orbent Papers, there we go. Amazing. make sure. Ooh, that's good to know. Nightmare isn't unbalanced. Is it possible to play just straight from new game? Because that would be pretty nice. I would be down to try that. You could be like a pet, cheering us up whenever we're feeling down. That's kind of creepy, Estelle. That's a little fucking creepy. And now that we've had a good breakfast, off to the central factory. Before we do that, I'd like to check in with the guild. I think it might be best to report on what happened yesterday, just be on the safe side. Okay, nice. I'm kind of only playing Nightmare on the original games because I've got a whole bunch of New Game Plus shit that I've carried over. They're still giving me, like, enough of a challenge. Like, boss fights are hard enough. And I have to put thought into stuff like the Raven Gang fight. That was tough. I actually clicked the wrong report button. Whereas playing, like, from fresh, I know on Trails 2, or Sky 2nd Chapter, is, like, the first boss fight is damn near impossibly RNG. Okay, I gotta go fight that monster. Or do I? I might be able to pick up some other quests now. Clinic? Not the clinic. Third floor workshop. There's a clean cat. Give me the quest! This need to be wearing the shoe. Nope. Here. Craft shoes, I think? Yes, very fascinating. Anything higher than normal? Yeah. I played Cold Steel 1 and 2 on hard, and that was enjoyable. There were some really good tough fights in it. Alright, I'm gonna go beat up that Rhino Cider, I don't remember. Triplanes, right? Yeah. Check. Fine. He's on the third floor workshop, god damn it. Sign room and Abyss Worms? I'm not sure which ones those were. Was that in 2nd Chapter? I think... Is that the one... It's like a wandering monster. It's an extermination quest, and it's just like a whole shitload of worms in this area. I was remembering those while I was passing through that area, I think. Well, as you can see, I'm trying to cut into the Black Ornament, but it hasn't been going very well. And click! It's a circular saw. It's made of a special alloy that can cut through basically anything. That ought to do it. It stopped. It's the same phenomenon as yesterday. seems like the black ormond is blocking out the functionality of other ormonds, interfering with them in some way. Chapter 8 Monster Request, Zeiss 1. Yeah, okay. And I doubt it was solely made for the purpose of killing the lights. This interference with nearby ormonds seems to spread out, moving from ormond to ormond like chain lightning. I put the range at about 5 arg, but if there are no ormonds powered on within that range, well, then that's where the effect stops. However, even with that knowledge, there's no way to know why it causes the machines to simply stop without getting a look inside it. Yeah, that was it. I can't remember how I beat them. I think I just killed one at a time. Anyone thought of trying fire? Maybe it'd melt down in the blast furnace or something. If we did that, the insides of it would melt too. And yeah, it might work. Orbital power, that which drives orbits to work, can't be used for this problem. We'll have to find a way that doesn't rely on any orbital energy. The combustion engine. It's a device that burns fuel to generate energy. The idea has been around for a long time, but it's very inefficient when compared to an orbital engine. All you need to work on them are standard tools. I've never even seen one of them. Gasoline! Go out and get the engine and gasoline. I've forgotten. It's a room with a bunch of orbital computers on the 5th floor. We store all kinds of information there for safekeeping. Yeah, I wiped on the Abyss Room of Worms like 2 or 3 times before I figured out not to just stick to my usual strategy of spam area of effect attacks because, you know, aerial is the best move in this fucking game. For the 5th floor, then. Now, can I say screw it and do other different quests? Tita's left the party again. God damn it. Oh, wow. Archives? Yeah, it was a hell of a fight, for sure. But again, like, once I just only hit one at a time, it actually got easier. Like, much more so. Clinic. That's the lab. I'm, like, looking for the workshop. Office? Where the fuck is the workshop? Whatever. Must be the operation. Hey, you two. I haven't seen you before, so you mind telling me what business you have in here? My name's Travis, senior engineer and supervisor. Professor Russell, he's not in trouble again, is he? 3rd floor? Okay. All around good kid. The cylindrical device is a type of computer. It's called the Capel. These days, they mostly get used to assist in airship navigation. This one is equipped for the fastest general-purpose data processing in the world. It can be used for anything from calculating material density to information retrieval. Okay, so I've beaten the 10th librarian quests. Books. There are no books in here. Wow, that's crazy. You may want to read other books in City of Zeiss archives. It's Central Factory, 2nd floor. Okay. Not too much to be concerned about here in this chapter so far. Yeah, sure, we got it. Okay, I lied. All that stuff went completely over my head. I'm sad you can't. Oh. Death of Professor C. Epstein in the Sovereign State of Le Mans. Professor A. Russell returns to the Liberal Kingdom. He proposes the spread of Orban technology to a chilly reception. Professor Russell forms a partnership with the Zeiss Clockmakers Union. Together they establish the Zeiss Engineering Factory, later renamed the Central Factory. Edgar III, after an inspection of the factory, donates a large amount of money to further its research. Professor Russell becomes the first factory chief. Honestly, I am so glad that I ended up playing them on PC because of all the PC features. But like, if I could have played this game in 2004, God, I would have loved it. "39 failed test flights before success was achieved." The Verne Company and Reinford Company. Reinford Company is from Cold Steel, / is set in Erebonia. The Liberal Orbalship Corporation is established and the transit commuter airship, the Lind, is commissioned. That's like one of the first orbital airships ever? What the hell? The Cecilia is commissioned, the Leibniz is commissioned, is completed. The partially underground factory in the Chaldea Hills is completed. Professor Russell resigns from his position as factory chief and is succeeded by Murdoch. Natural science and medical research divisions are founded. The passenger ship Eterna sinks in Calvert Waters. Crown Prince Judas dies. The Orbal Network, a joint venture with the Epstein Foundation, is publicly announced. Outbreak of the Hundred Days War. The central factory is taken by the Erebonian Empire. Professor Russell develops patrol airships at Layston Fortress, which are used to mount a highly effective counteroffensive since who becomes central to the Royal Army. The Burl and Erebonia sign a peace accord. Orbit exports to the Erebonian Empire resume. Version 1.0 of the Propel Orbital Computer is completed. Development commences on the high-speed cruiser, the Arce. The Arce is completed and flight tests commence. Oh, God. I'm not reading all this shit. Orbans do the thing that they're with the stuff and they make the magic happen. And it's super good, and they go zoom, and the cannons, and the weapons, and the engines, and the vroom, bang, poof, 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 pow. Tactical Orbans are basically handguns, and you used to shoot people with them. Wait, no, never mind. Yeah, there is so much. If I didn't have the turbo feature, it would be a slog for sure. It's just, like, so nice. Like, I don't know, whenever it slowly pans to any area, it's like, alright, hurry the fuck up. Resonance phenomenon. Number owned, 1. Owner Maintenance Chief Gustav. Gasoline. Orbit Manufacturing Factory. Olive Vehicle? Ooh. Owner No Data. Repository Underground Factory Entrance. Oh, really? Trails from Zero? Got a translation patch? I would love to play those games. I really, really want to play those games because I have not played those games. Hey, there we go. Oh. Calvert gasoline there in the warehouse. Okay, so Calvert is Alberta, I understand. Holy, here we are. Originally, it was just a series of tubes for sending products back and forth, and then we developed it and advanced it, and now it's just a series of tubes for sending memes back and forth. A Google translated patch? Yeah, I'm not about that. A proper one. Okay, I'm definitely gonna look into that. tendency to fireball. Pshaw. Where is it? Here it is. I want to investigate this thing. I don't know when to trigger this quest. But the cutoff is before way later stuff. Yeah. So I don't need to worry about it too much. Airfield. Went to Layston Fortress 2 or 3 days ago. Okay. Geofront translation? Perfect. Thank you, man. Thank you for telling me. Airship! Wedge just turned around. Okay. Or public airship orange. That's the central factory vessel, the Leibniz. The same model as the public transport, but it's had several modifications. A flying factory. We need to talk to him.
To assassinate him? Thank you for the top tip, Mr. Accomplice.
Central factory fleet. I'm definitely going to look into that and probably play it after third chapter then. Or Trails in the Sky the Third, or whatever the hell the nomenclature for that is. Hands it to us. Cool. This is where I wanted to be. It's, yeah, this could be in a very long while. It's taken me quite a bit to get through, first chapter, but it's nice because I know what the hell I'm doing mostly. Yeah, the workshop was what I was asking about, but what I was actually looking for was the lab on the fourth floor. I wanted to check with the shoe guy. Your brute strength was most useful, girl. Cold steel and a switch to 3D. I don't mind it. I liked it, actually. I liked cold steel a lot. I'm a bit conflicted about what it's doing with its plot and the plot of every other game. Converts the energy given by the burning gas to power the tools, so this way they don't need orbital energy. And click! I love that he says that every time. It's definitely a lot louder than orbital engines. That's one of its drawbacks, yes. But now we need to fear activating the Black Orbit this way. Yeah, I got the tomato already. That's some serious sparkage. Okay, shut it down for now. We've seen how much physical punishment it can take, and how much punishment our ears can take as well. A tiny scratch is faintly visible. That's it? But if we keep at it, I believe this would work. We're going to go through quite a few saw blades, though. Professor, can I talk to you for a second? I just received a message from the hotel in Elmo for you. The orbital-powered pump that supplies the hot water for their spa has broken down. Since they can't make any money like this, they'd like for you to come and try and fix it. Ah, you must be kidding. Damn it, of all the times for this to happen. No, that pile of junk is at least 40 years old. The younger techs have no idea what to do with anything that's not state-of-the-art. What a pain in the... Grandpa, maybe I could go over and do the repairs, you think? There are monsters out on the road. That's a problem. Why don't you let us handle it? It's a bracer's duty to ensure the safety of the borough's roadways. Therefore, seeing that Tito arrives at her destination safely is our responsibility. Don't worry about it. Kids shouldn't sweat the details. BRB, boys. Okay, now we should have access to all of our quests. Bunga bunga, talky questy. There should be a guy in here with a quest. I think? What? Fourth floor. That's the roof. Controller! Sensitive control stick. You wanna take your drugs, right? Right. Don't they just cure sleep? Where the hell? How do we get this test thing? What the fuck? Okay, she's right at the door. Cricket needs to go out, so I will be back in a bit. I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. I'm gonna get the guide back up. There we go. Yeah, the tomato sandwich thing, right? Is the bitter tomato's whole purpose, I thought, was curing sleep. You just broke up with that guy, too. Maybe they do something else. I'll have to check. Okay. I think... I have no idea how to find the haulage vehicle quest. Actually, you know what? God damn it, sorry Fubar. Yes, thank you. I thought I was missing something. that and then that. There we go. Okay, seriously, where the hell do I get the fucking 40 craft points? Okay, that's busted. Oh hey, I can get another one apparently. I don't need the clinic, really, do I? No. Huh. Oh. Okay, what about now? That's a new scene. We now go back in? I'm sorry that I'm like this, but, you know, I know that there are quests kicking around, so... No, I don't think this quest is activated from there. I think you just find them on the road. But I know for a fact that this quest is activated by talking to this dude. I just don't know when. Okay. House, Bracer Guild. Oh, holy god, okay. That's a lot. Okay. Filch some cigarettes that were being stored in the cabinet in the clinic. Oh, yeah, okay. Rear Road, Mercury Viper, Haulage Vehicle Search. Oh, Jesus, I forgot to... Okay, no, we're good. This is all of our side stuff. My favorite S-craft? God, that's a good question. In this game or in any other game? I really liked Laura's in Cold Steel, well, 1 and 2. I forget what it was called. It wasn't Radiant Lion. It was her first one, actually. Although I liked Radiant Lion, too. I'm really partial to Beatdown, actually, at Gates in this one. That one's really cool. Alpha Strega. The Strega Corporation is conducting research on new projects to bring to market. This particular test requires you to wear these prototypes around to various places. Upon the successful completion of this test, all that will remain is to put them into production. Hey, just a second there, buddy. Did you just say the Strega Corporation? Yeah, I just picked up a second one. I didn't realize. God, how many do you need? And also, can you just buy them? Also, I'm pretty sure there are things that drop them, aren't there? Oh, great Adios. Thank you for bestowing upon me, us, this magnificent job. What? This isn't prayer. Don't mind her. Estelle's something of a sneaker collector. More to the point, she pretty much adores the Strega brand ones. Sneaker mania! Yes, absolutely. Please don't pray at me again. From the Elmo Spa to the Wolf Fort, all the way to the Sanctum Gate. And when you feel you've tested them out properly, bring them back to me. Alright, we gotta make sure we equip them, of course. They're actually pretty good, I think. They're super not. They're actually terrible.
Oh well.
Tomato! Hey, a sec. You just have to leave when you enter. Oh no, dude! What have you done to my honest playthrough of carrying over all my New Game Plus quartz and equipment and using them as I see fit? You've ruined it! Alright, let me get like one more, and then we're done. There we go. Alright. Ruined it completely. Clinic, we gotta get the smokes. It's time, you're not getting away. You just got 99 here? Jesus. That must have taken a minute or two. Eyewitness. Antoine?
Meow.
Do I have to talk to the first people or can I go to directly who I know did it? Let us find out. cat. Oh, cat. Just one more, he says. Oh, I really like Chloe's too, because it's so just like panic button and godlike because of that. Hugh, Hugo. Yeah. Not you. I forget what it's called. Lichtkrieg or something. I don't know. Fine. We'll just finish this first. Travis is in here.
Meow.
Six crease, yeah. It's just like, fucking everybody's dead. Pop the S-craft. Yum. Is there a clue in the computer? No, I don't think so. Second floor. Boop. What's this? Oh, yeah, is that Father Kevin's? You went to the clinic today, didn't you?
No.
Sure, go ahead. Aren't they just like... Apparently no one was considerate enough to hide some money here, alas. Damn. There's nothing of interest. Sadly, no one seems to have left any exciting or incriminating papers for you to find. Found back room key. Oh, okay. Yeah, because he's a big deal in the third game, hey. Cigarette. Oh, you've got it all wrong. Need to focus on your health, we say to the person who had a... You know what? Nah. Really hope I didn't, like, fuck that up somehow. No. Oh yeah, you do get him for a bit there, don't you? God, you get so many party members. Okay, basement. We don't need Antoine, or don't have Antoine anymore. We now talk to this guy. Who is it? Oh, right. It's on the Trap Plains Road, I forgot. Potent ingredient, product testing. Oh, yeah. Oh, where do I have to... Oh god, we have to go all the way back to Airlighten, actually. Let's go. Do I still have Photocon? Sure do. there a trigger for, like, being here or anything? I don't think so. I think just, Yeah, the end of first chapter for me was like, I kind of just used, like, whoever and didn't really have great party comp. I'm gonna try and maybe change that. If I can, I'm not really sure if I'll be able to, though. Oh yeah, you can. Here's a bunch of stuff. Sounds like things are pretty grand foobar there. Ha 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 ha. Anyway, been to Airletten. I'm gonna double check that I got all the chests in here because there's supposed to be like 7 and I feel I only got like 4. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, somebody said the word foobar as in like fucked up beyond all repair and I made the obvious joke. Sorry. 4? What was I at? That sounds about like what I used. I might have had Chloe instead of Zin. No, I had all of you. I know I had Zin, and I didn't, like having him. He just kind of didn't do anything for me, really. I don't know. Does the Chaldea Limestone Cave count? Oh, hey. Because you've already been here. Not really. Oh, hey, you can actually come here? Weird. Penguins. I feel like I should do some fighting of the penguins. Just because, like, I'm pretty not leveled in this area yet. Skilled with water based arts. We'll strike that motherfucker. Oh, okay. Fuck.
Prepare to meet your doom!
Let's see what she's got. Oh, blind. Yeah. Thundergod Kick is bugged? How so? I don't even remember it. I definitely did not use him at all. I used a lot of a gate in second chapter, though. Get impeded! Oh yeah, Tita's gonna be fucking godlike this chapter, I think. Tita. That was pretty good experience for 2 enemies that didn't get to hit me. Purple Penguin. Pink Penguin. Spontaneously sing the court of Nate. Hello? Are you hearing? We're doing that.
Come on! Take! Prepare to meet your doom!
I love that line so much. We're gonna go Ghost Strike. Oof. Damn it, if she could stand right here, she could hit both of them. But Josh was in the way. It's every enemy once for all the enemies hit in the same attack. So like if you hit 4 things, it hits everything 4 times? Is that right? Oh Jesus, okay. That's pretty good. Is that his S craft or just a regular craft? I don't remember.
Let's move out.
Oh, Jesus. Also, we're gonna do something really silly. We're gonna give him the headband. And her the belt. So that she just always has craft points for a smoke cannon. Do you think he sees me? I don't think he sees me. I think this is a perfectly normal example of a wild orange penguin. Fucking stuck on that rock. Oh no, he turned around just in time. I figured he would. Oh, what the fuck? Yeah, penguins hurt a lot, apparently. Where is her S-crab? Not useful right now. I can't hit both of them. I can hit both of them? Hell yeah. This might suck. I know some of them throw fish, and I don't know which ones they are. But, whatever. Oh, he's in a blinded lane. Oh, right, because that's only a smoke cannon effect. Okay, he can't do anything. Cool. Okay, he also can't do anything. Cool. Let's do morale. Penguin, fuck! Ow! Good god, that hurt like hell. I think we need this one to not do anything. And I think we need... Ah, damn it. I was really hoping she could get all three this time, but... Yeah, that's fine. She just has a Gatling gun. I actually don't know if I've ever seen her S-crash before. Scary. Someone's dying this turn. Oh no, it's Joshua. Ugh. We're gonna pop it, because you know what? If you don't, someone's dead. Oh no! Okay, alright, okay. They're saying there's a chance. A smoke cannon is that much? Christ. Ow. I'm not sure exactly what you mean by retry offset. Is that when it gets easier when you lose? God damn it, who's he gonna hit? This is really dumb. I shouldn't be struggling with penguins like this, but alas, here I am struggling with penguins like this. If we do Latira on her, and then she just runs up and revives. Gosh, what we're doing. Hooray! We planned it out. Don't kill her. Jesus Christ. Okay. I'm just making goddamn sure. Oh, it doesn't? Okay. I don't know, I couldn't tell you, really. I mean, I have retried, but sometimes I'll just get out to the title screen because I'm like, you know what, I just got hacked, so... Well, that was penguins. That's what that was. Goddamn. Chest is empty. Nefarious! Okay, that's just a rock. Get his ass! Alright, we got his ass. Oh no, there's like five. Oh, when does he get the fucking good one, dude? Gas, hurls fish. Ah, that one. That one hurls fish. I'm gonna kill that one. Well, I wasn't delay that one and nearly kill it, but not quite.
Come on.
I didn't get much use out of Cheetah in my first playthrough, and I think she's going to be a little bit the star of the show. I love their sound effects, actually. They're so dumb. Yeah. Oh, hell yeah, she doesn't even have to move. Don't you do it. Good. Super good experience right now. What the fuck? Did I get turned around? Maybe. Maybe. I'm feeling it definitely. Really broken third? Ooh, okay. I'll have to look out for that. Definitely got turned around. Ah! Oh god, right. There's so many penguins in these chests. Might actually suck. This might actually suck a lot. Oh my good god. Do not do the gas attack. Okay, that's fine. You know what? Well... Oh Christ. I can flicker a couple. Gonna go for it. Yeah, this is some dicey shit here. I'm worried she might have to move too far for this. She doesn't have to move at all. He just broke it. Impeded that. When would she get out in Earth Wall? Immediately, nice. I'm just gonna steal that critical round with Tita, and I think that's gonna be it, really. Penguin.
Prepare to get your doom! Come on, everyone!
Yeah! Hell yeah!
Scary.
Only two we flickered, but that's still a lot. I don't like how close this guy is. Although, I also don't like how that one is attacking. Yeah, we're gonna do this. That's a good chunk of damage on that one. We get three. Oh, I was hoping she could get right there, but she doesn't have enough movement for it. You know what? She doesn't have a wall up right now, so I'm just going to comment it. So she doesn't have to move. Okay. Good, good, good. Ow. I'm upset he got another turn after he was paralyzed, but like, whatever. But the wheel strike, she did. Alright, go get him. Wow. That went pretty well. Right. Holy god.
Good to go.
Penguins. G-Impact. It's empty. What depraved individual would do something like this? What I'm using. Nope. No, it really, really isn't. Range plus four still? Holy god. Thor's hammer. I should just snap and put Thor's hammer on and just steamroll this whole chapter. Is it after my ass? No, it's not. Got quick aerial. Morale. I keep thinking morale is 30 when it's hurricane, it's 30. Oh, that one did not hit that at all. What was the blue penguin's deal? Nothing?
Prepare to meet your doom!
Half expected her to walk backwards there, honestly. I kind of wanted to position him for a flicker on, like, two things, but... D&D is in about 40 minutes, so I've basically set a cutoff time for myself of in 20 minutes. Oh, she did have to move on that one. Get interrupted. God damn it, level up somebody. Preferably like everybody, but I'm not picky. Oh god. If I go all the way to the end of this place. Ah! I'm pissed. I'm so mad. Are you fucking serious? God damn it. This might be really bad. Damn, I was actually really going for that KO there.
Come on.
Yeah. Nice. Gonna nuke them. Oh god, he's not dead. Oh, okay, he's blind. Doesn't matter. Ow!
Not now.
Piss! Well, let's learn some stuff. Let's learn some specialty eggnog. Actually, this. Yep. Ow, god fucking damn it. Oh shit, but she doesn't have it. Oh, doesn't do that. I'm just gonna use a reviving bomb.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Black Fang is really good. Okay, so I was an idiot on my first playthrough, and like, it was in second chapter. No, okay. I thought that his very last S-craft was like a different functioning move than other stuff. So like, I was really dumb and didn't set it for the last boss. Really dumb. How do I stop these things from fucking murdering me in this turn? It's like, honest to God, like there is nothing I can do right now. And it's frustrating as shit. They're just gonna murder me. Oh, this one's at 9 HP. Are you fucking serious? Estelle, you had one fucking job, you useless fucking piece of shit. Okay, alright, good, great, awesome. Fuck y'all. No. Yeah, I got penguined is what I got. Fuck. Dude. He hit. Bastard. Oh, no, they're not dead. Oh, Jesus Christ, this is getting out of hand. What I really want is his all-hitting move, Evil Eye. Not all-hitting move, but Evil Eye is so goddamn good. Even though it's like 40 craft points. I'll get something's dying. The one that's not blinded should die. Although, the one that's not blinded, that's perfectly healthy, that's about to go... Oh, he won't kill it. 865. I could reasonably kill one of these two. Let's go with this one and see how it goes. Damn. Guard. Good. Fuck, okay. Alright. Oh my god. Okay, what the fuck? I killed one, missed another one, because Estelle is continuing to be useless. Oh, he missed. Guard and miss. Okay.
Beta's turn. Smoke cannon.
Why don't I not use this blessed little girl? Because penguins weren't fucking me up this hard. AT delay is absolutely very silly. I spammed a lot of it in, like, late game and stuff. I'm sad he doesn't have two straight craft points right now, but... Stupid penguins, goddamn. Although, I do appreciate the extra experience that I get. Seriously! Oh. When did Estelle level up? Was it... It wasn't that... He did level up at some point, okay. 21. 21? Have I just been reading the goddamn level wrong this whole time? I think I have. That was hell. It was really good in Cold Steel when they added resistance to it on a lot of enemies. Specifically a lot of bosses. Also, I have played the game before, but I'm kind of trying to take my viewers through it. Relatively spoilery free. But try not to give away too much if you would not mind. Although if you're like, oh, you know, that one boss at the place, as vague as you can, like, that's cool with me. Hurls fish with incredible strength. Oh, he's got a critical. Let's kill this thing. Yeah. Oh wow, he killed it. Okay. Didn't actually expect that. You know what? He does need more craft points.
Yeah, tiny penguins.
There's literally just these tiny penguins. Adorably lethal. Prepare to meet your doom! Sick. Yeah. But man, the things that don't just get like... Why did I save before this? I knew it wasn't going to be a monster chest. The things that don't resist it, though, get just like... Literally... cheesed out by it. Here's another one, okay. Monsters! Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Can I hit two things at once? I can hit those two things. Sick. If I hit the white one? Yeah, that's all four. Nice. Oh shit. This leaves her without craft points to blind everything. Or at least for a little bit. Oh, never mind. Oh no, she's only got 12 from that. She only got 12 from that? Lame. Sorry. White Penguin fled! Bastard. Which one is using arts? Nobody is targeted for arts. Ooh. I should really kill the one that's getting like critical round though. Or should I? I'm pretty defensive against arts. This we can kill these two things. Just the one, okay. Oh no, that was a bad idea. Oh, that was a really bad idea! About that eggnog.
We're good to go.
Oh, hey. Oh. Okay. Oh, I'm so fine. And there's something. Oh, no, 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 okay. Come on, cannon.
It's
fucking penguins, dude. Don't kill anybody. Okay, thank God. Specialty eggnog. Good. Uh-oh. good. God damn it! All the things you could have hit.
No!
Oh no. God, this sucks. Let's kill you. Okay. Nice. Diamond dust. Ow. Don't we have a cure 500? Rose.
We're good to go.
Yes. Get fucking meat, I swear to God. Actually, a Latia would be pretty good right now, actually. Fuck it. Gonna nuke you. Swear to God. Diamond dusting asshole. Ugh.
Yeah.
Yeah, you should be alright. Ow. Okay. Why did you? Okay. It's fine. And now we'll drop a Latira. Who's dying? Don't need to dual strike him. Here we do. Then Tita can just wipe him all out in one. Or Joshua can just slaughter him. Ow! Oh, and their blind just wore off, so, like, just in case you didn't kill them, but. EP 3. Nada. Zilch. Zero. Fucking penguin, dude. I would like to make more of those. Too bad I don't have any vintage wines. Fuck. Really think I could have done that better, but like, I got that specialty eggnog somewhere. I just forget where. Oh, hey, this is Josh McNaught. Fuck it. Double fuck it. Kill its prey with a single attack? Well, that's worrying. That's okay. Woo!
Prepare to meet your doom!
Oh, right, it's 30, isn't it? Yes, yes, bunch up right in front of Joshua, who has no craft points to flick above the crap. Damn it, even with EP 3. Or hit 3. Oh, she doesn't have 30 for Hurricane. Thank you. Okay.
That's that thing.
I really want Joshua to get that extra level. What time have we got? 7:30 looks like. Yeah. Well, yeah. Not dead. Ow. Hey, who's it was? 478, 10. You know what? He shouldn't need to do this. Okay, yeah. Alright, that is my... I'm not sure if that can be heard, but that's my screen ending alarm going off. Come on, Joshua, just get the level, please.
We did it!
Yes. Oh, and even Titus should get it, too. Nice. Okay, 22 and 21. I don't know how many more chests I need in here. This is awkward and unfortunate, but it's apparently not in that corner. We're gonna try and make our way back to town now. And by try, I mean succeed, because I have cloak and I don't care. Hey, there's one. Cool. Mr. Tiddles was here. Alright, how the fuck do we get out of here? This way. Nice. I think that should be all the chests in here, actually. Penguins, dude. Fucking penguins. Just a nightmare on nightmare, apparently. Although we're probably doing a lot better, considering. Well, probably much less of a problem now that I've gotten like two levels for everybody. Maybe just one. I don't remember. Alright. So I'm gonna save there. We've got a whole bunch of walking and other side quests to do and a bunch of monsters to fight, and so that's all on the agenda for next stream, which will be, I think this Friday will be when I'll play Trails next. So, thank everybody for watching and coming out. Hope y'all enjoyed. I'm gonna go ahead and double check or double save because I'm neurotic. I'm gonna exit the game. And it's